Da-da-da. Hello everybody, welcome. Yeah, it seems like it's been a few days since we did a clip, and that's because I've been busy doing this and that and coming and going, etc. Such is life. Anyway, what I'm actually doing right now, just to give you a sort of overview of my chaos in here, or organized chaos, I should say. Yeah, I'm in the middle actually of packing a kiln. I've got to get some pots over to England to St. Ives because we are having a. Hang on, I'll show you. I've got a poster. Yeah, we're having a third generation exhibition at the St. Ives Pottery in Cornwall. The Leach Pottery, I should say, at St. Ives. So my elder brother Johnny, my other elder brother Jeremy, my cousin Philip, and myself. So it's an exhibition that's going to be running from the 20th of July to the 16th of September over there in England. So anyway, just to mention that, but that's what I'm working towards, and I've got some pots. So I just thought I'd just give you a very brief. I'm actually in the middle of doing a pot here on the side here, so let's get down there, and then we're going to be jumping off somewhere else probably. And yeah, as you can see, I've got some pots over there that are waiting. There's some tankards that are there. Probably the tankards are not going actually to England, but yeah, I'm actually just doing this bottle here, and maybe we can just briefly talk about that as we do. We don't want to dwell on it for too long, but you know. Anyway, yeah, this is a little one of those little squashed. You know, I threw it round and then I squashed it on each side, or paddled it, and then I did a hackamy white slip, you see. And so now I'm at that point where I'm putting on an iron oxide decoration here. Now I just better make sure we're in the picture while we do this. And the light is shining in through the door rather strongly at the minute. So yeah, I've got some iron oxide here, which is just iron oxide and a red clay in a percentage of 75% iron oxide and 25% red clay. So, yeah, I've just done some leaves here on the one side, and gonna do some leaves again on this side. So, yeah. Now, we always with brushwork, what you want to be is bold and decisive. Hesitation is really not a good idea. You want to load the brush so that the pigment flows off the end of the brush. And you really want to make sure that the pigment, you've got enough pigment there on the brush so it flows right to the end of the tip of the brush, you see. So I'm just doing. There's so many leaves in the garden at the moment, you know, that you can't help but yourself by putting leaves. So lots of leaves, you see, today. So there you are. So, you know, if you're going to do this kind of decoration. So Now don't be too fussy about it. Be bold and decisive and just let it flow. You know, one of the things about nature is not always organized. When you look at leaves, when you look at trees, everything is a little bit random. So that gives us a little bit of liberty, doesn't it? To be, you know, a little bit loose. Nature is very loose. So in order to emulate or be inspired by nature, so you also got to be a little loose, not too tight. Well, we've done some leaves there, but we need a few stalks, don't we? So stalks, lines, you see, some lines, but not too exact, you know, just loose. You've got to let it be loose. So I'm just putting in a few little lines here, which are barely, yeah, just let the brush dance along there, you see. So let me just show you that. Let's just get a bit close up here. Dee, 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 dee. So hopefully, so you can see there, you see, it's not too tight, is it? You don't want it to be too tight. You just want to keep it flowing. And so you can see the stems as well as the leaves. So there's another one done. Now then, now I may, and over there where my camera is pointing, you can see there's a banding wheel. Because what I sometimes do is, I think I will do in this case, I'm going to spray it, you see. I'm going to get some of this unwashed wood ash, and I'm going to blow it over the outside of the pot, you see. Before I do that, I'm just going to quickly show you some others though that I've done that are waiting to be sprayed. Just a few down here. Here's a bowl, you see. Now at first I did the Hakami white slip with the brush, and then I came along with the iron oxide and did these dots. Now this is going to have wood ash sprayed again here. Exactly the same. You can see the white from the Hakami, and then the brush on top. You see there's a little bit of movement there, a bit of freedom, as you would expect in nature. Again here, much the same kind of idea. These are all waiting now here. I'm just going to be putting a little bit of wood ash sprayed over these, you see. So the thing is to be inspired, you see, but also to be creative, to be original. You can copy something else by all means, because copying is a great way of learning, copying. Here's some other things. These are not decorated at the moment, but they're going to be sprayed with wood ash. These, just these little dishes, you see, with the little make-believe lugs on the end. So there's that. So what else? Yeah, over here, boom, 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 boom. We're on the move again. On the move again. Well, I've got their pot, you see, that I glazed. This guy here. I glazed him, but he's waiting to be cleaned off, you see, down here on the foot. Like that. And now I put him on this tray, this warming tray, because that's a great place to put pots for them to dry off. Now this particular pot has got a transparent glaze over the outside, but underneath it's got a hackamy and a little bit of iron oxide spotting. So what we're going to do is I'm going to put him over there on the side of the kiln, because I'm just why don't I just bring the camera. Yeah, I told you that, you see, this was going to be a bit of a roving session. Well, as you can see down there, I've already put the bottom shelf in. You can see the cone down there, my cone 10, which of course I have to line up with the spy hole here to make sure he's right opposite, you see, so when I can see him. Ooh, it seems there's some insect in the mouth of my pot here. Can you see that insect there? I don't know what he is. You coming out? Are you friend or foe? Well, you're going in the kiln anyway. So I'm going to put that pot down here. Now across here you can see on this shelf I've got, what I do is I put a half shelf. You see that shelf down there? That's like a half of a shelf. So I put the half shelf on here. So that allows me a little bit of room here on this side for some higher pots if I want to. Okay. So here you can see some of those squared off dishes that we did. Well, they're not really square, are they? But they're kind of squarish. And these are those dishes I spoke about that which are nice to eat out of, I think, because they're sort of flat, but you can use a fork and push the food to the side of the plate and get it onto the fork, you see. And this here is the GP bowl with a pouring lip that has got the score marks on the inside, because that's going to be for use with a pestle. That's for grinding spices and things like that. So what else? We've got some all these bowls here, you see. Now these all have had a hackamy underneath, under decoration, under the glaze I should say, a hackamy decoration under glaze with an iron oxide pigment decoration. So, and those are those ones over there, these ones are raw. These ones have not been bisque fired at all, but just have got a wood ash and red clay glaze over. So that's that. Okay, folks, put this back on the tripod because I know you're all getting dizzy. Why doesn't he stop moving the camera around? Anyway, I've got a few more pots to get into this kiln, as you can see. And, oh, I know what we were going to do. We were going to do that wood ash over there, weren't we? Let's see if I can get the tripod over here. I do this wood ash spraying, you see, in this little, kind of in this little corner here, because Ooh, I'm going to have to go around the other side of the table, so I haven't disappeared, okay? I'm coming back. Okay. Okay, we're here. Yeah, so I do my wood ash spraying over here, you see. So, now what I will do here, I'm going to take my brush, just going to load my brush here with a little bit of pigment, okay? Because I want to, you see now, I'm tapping the brush like that. Now, if you do that, you'll get a random spattering, you see. Dee 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 dee, la la, whoop 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 whoop. So I've got a kind of random spattering going on there. Now, I like that sometimes, to be able to do that. It can make the clay a little bit more interesting, the clay body, because sometimes the clay body is a little bit, you know what, the clay, how we use our clay, it's like eating McDonald's, you know, it's all processed, isn't it? Everything is air floated, all the clay, so everything is the same particle size, and you end up with a very uniform but actually quite a boring clay body without much free iron or other natural contaminants in the clay body. You don't find, everything is very refined, you see. This is like refined salt or refined white sugar. It's got not a lot of interest in the clay body. So in order to sometimes, that's why I sometimes just spatter it a bit with iron, you see, just to give it a little bit more interest. So this is the wood ash, which is just wood ash from my fireplace, which is, I sieve it and add it to water in this container. And then with the atomizer, so together with that, by blowing here, and by squeezing the bottle as well at the same time, which pushes the mixture up here, you see, to the nozzle. So when I blow, so I'm going to, lightly blow some wood ash over the, especially over the non-decorated area, you see. I'm going to just give it a light spray on the face here. Comme ça. And now I put a little bit more heavy spray on the top shoulder, because that can create interest. Can make you a bit dizzy, this, if you're not careful. So after you've sprayed, you want to hold the table firmly in case you faint on the floor. No, seriously, it can make you feel a bit lightheaded sometimes. So there we go, I've got this wood ashy effect now sprayed over, which hopefully will create an interesting effect. Okay, folks, well, please visit my website, simonleachpottery.com, and yeah, we keep practicing, okay? See you soon. Bye-bye. Dee 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 dee.